protect them. And they understand that not all intelligence is perfect. They understand that a president must make decisions to defend the national interest, even if he doesn't have all the facts at his hand. He could use that to his advantage here. He does not need to go out on a limb like he did with Laura Ingraham and give out specifics.
Maybe not on a limb, but you do need to defend the argument that it's imminent, right? You have to defend that element. Otherwise, it's illegal.
I think he can go out there and say that it was imminent. We had good intelligence to work on. We know what this guy's record is. Even the Democrats admit this guy is a terrorist and a murderer of innocents. We know he's a bad guy.
We all agree that killing him was good. He should be dead.
All that's good.
None of that equals imminent.
Right, and then what it was anticipatory.
Two or 3 weeks is imminent when you only get so many opportunities.
It was not imminent. And at the end of the day, listen, we're playing with national security. You know, the number one objective for the president is to protect the homeland, right? But to keep American lives safe. And for him to basically, I believe, just act off belief or a feeling, not the intelligence, not the numbers, not these departments that are there to make sure that they give him the intelligence so he can make these decisions. But I think what you see is a waffling, a flip-flop from this president. And again, I think that he needs to, today, tomorrow, show this imminent factual evidence that made him go over and attack Iran. And if he can prove it, then great. But if he can't, then we got to call it what it is, that he was lying. He's taking us to war. He's putting American troops' lives on the line, basically on re-election efforts and political beliefs. Because if it's not imminent, if it's not factual, and it's not based on intelligence, then what is it?